Boxing Eagle here. If you like this video, make sure you hit the like button and also subscribe to the channel and hit the bell icon on the top of your screen to get notified when the latest new content drops. One. What up, fight world? It's your boy Ego, and I'm back with some more boxing. First of all, make sure you guys like and subscribe. Follow me on social media at Boxing Ego. Like Visa, I'm everywhere you want to be. Now, there was a great PBC on Fox card yesterday, Saturday. It was a quadruple header. Caleb Plant won, Jared Swift Hurd won, and you have Dominic Brazil who won, and another heavyweight, Deontay Wilder, title defense, he beat Gerald Washington. I've already done my post-fight videos. Now, in case you have not heard, there was some kind of altercation that ensued between Dominic Brazil, who was on the undercard, and Alabama's own WBC champion Deontay Wilder. So I'm gonna back up the train and talk about what was alleged or whatever you want to call it, and then I want to get to Deontay Wilder's response, which you guys seen in the title. Now this is the two fighters. They put on a classic. There's also an article on the website. Make sure you guys check it out. We working hard. All the fights are covered. Wilder, there's a write-up for Jared Swift Hurd and also the Dominic Brazil fight. So make sure you guys check those out. Link in the description in case you want to check those out. This was a war, the Dominic Brazil fight. It was just an all-out war, like kind of a slugfest. Some good fights on last night. Deontay Wilder got a stoppage, and I thought he was losing the fight, but he has that equalizing power. Now, back to the claims. Dominic Brazil, he says, first off, I want to take the time to thank God that both me and my opponent came out of the fight unharmed and safe last night. Secondly, I want to address the fact that Deontay Wilder and a mob of about 20 people unprovokedly, is that a word? Unprovokedly attacked my team and my family in the lobby last night. My coach and I were blindsided by sucker punches, and my team was assaulted as well all in front of my wife and kids. This cowardly attack has no place in boxing, and believe me, will not go unpunished. So that's what he claims. TMZ doesn't really show much, but TMZ has the clip or a piece of the clip. It looked like after some of it had happened, either that or the vantage point, the camera angle, you can't really see much. I'll try to link to that. And Wilder, successful in his title defense, again, check out the articles. He said post-fight about Gerald Washington, I knew he was going to come in excited to fight for a world title. We just kept calm and found my rhythm. I really knew he was going to tire out, and when he did, I took advantage. As I've been saying, I'm looking to unify the division. I think it's critical to have one fighter and one champion, and that's Deontay Wilder. Let's hope Joseph Parker is ready for me, because I'm definitely ready for him. Again, more for the on the write-up, go to the website. So his response is right here. So Deontay Wilder says, first and foremost, it is my honor to be the WBC heavyweight champion of the world, and it was a wonderful experience defending my title in my home state of Alabama last night. Holding this title is a privilege and one that I cherish. I know that this privilege comes with a great responsibility, not just inside the ring, but also how I conduct myself outside the ring. I am disappointed that attention has been diverted away from my title defense and my conduct has come into question. It is important that I set the record straight with regards to the incident that took place in the hotel last night with Brazil. He goes on to say, we all know there are two sides to every story, and the story the world has been told thus far is wrong. Brazil confronted my brother in the arena and told him he would kill my entire family. There were many witnesses to this. My brother was the one provoked. I was very upset when I heard about that incident. This is my only brother, and I am his keeper. I did want to confront Brazil man to man and face to face, but just because we are fighters doesn't mean we always have to act with violence, and my only intention was to speak with him. I'm sure many of you have seen me on many occasions, and those that know me knows I don't travel with the big entourage. In fact, I don't believe in it. I was accused of having a mob of 20 people, and that's just ridiculous. I approached Brazil in the lobby alone as my team stood back, and immediately a member of his team grabbed me. My brother was punched. People close to Brazil yelled cuss words at him, or at me, and I lost my cool. My only concern was the safety of my family member and my only brother. First, I did not throw a punch. Second, I did not make a comment about Brazil's children. Anything else you have heard is a lie, because no matter how heated or protective I may be, I'm not the kind of man to go after someone's kids. I understand how this incident looks given that I am a heavyweight champion, but I want to ensure people I did not act in the manner Brazil has claimed, and the videos are clear about that. The statements from his team were untrue and a defamation of my character. I will go to great lengths to prove that. So, immediate response from the WBC heavyweight champion of the world. And a lot of people sent me this, and I had already heard about it. And they're saying, hey, do a video. But real talk, Boxing Ego as a brand, I mean, it's not just because I met Wilder, and out of respect for him, cool dude, but you got to have a level of integrity. I've seen Brazil at fights too. I wasn't there. That's the reality of the situation. I wasn't there. So I can only go off what is being said. So I purposely did not do a video this morning based on only one testimony on, I mean, I'm like, damn, they're saying Wilder said this about his kids and that. So I wanted more information to pour out, as it always does. TMZ later came with the video, and you know what I mean? More things come out. So now, at, like I said, with the Boxing Ego brand, what I tried to do as much as possible is try to get to the facts. I still don't know the facts, but I'll leave that for you guys to interpret. And that's both people's sides. I went over both sides, the Brazil side and the Deontay Wilder side. Again, I was not there, so I don't know what happened. I don't know what ensued. I don't know if he threatened his kids. I know a lot of people, seeing this is what's wrong with social media. A lot of people, I seen comments, they just heard the Brazil side and his testimony, and they said, I knew it, Deontay Wilder's a punk. And a lot of people don't like Wilder or say he picks bums or whatever, so they use that as a catalyst to just jump down his throat. Me, I try to, you know what I mean, without knowing the facts, and like Wilder said, two sides to every story, I try to wait for more information to come before I give my own opinion, you know what I mean? A lot of my opinion videos, it's when more information is already out. I have enough, and I've already have enough data, and I've collected enough to, at that point, say my input. You know what I mean? Like fight predictions. But for a situation that I was not there for, Boxing Ego wasn't there to cover this fight in Alabama, I don't know what happened. So that's why I'm providing you guys with the story from both. Dominique Brazil said this, his wife said what they thought happened, and what they, their testimony or whatever. This is his wife, what she put. This is Dominique Brazil's wife. Shout out to my dude Crown Boxing. I was there at the fights and in the lobby. Our 8-year-old son was cheering for Gerald Washington. Dominique Brazil and Gerald Washington are friends. You'll see like pictures on their Instagram and stuff together. And Wilder's brother didn't like that. So when Wilder won, his brother jumped up and started cussing at my husband, who had my 5-year-old on his lap and our 8-year-old son sitting by his side. My husband told him to calm down and not do that in front of our kids. That's all that happened. His brother obviously added more to the story and got Wilder's panties in a bunch. Dominique, myself, our corner, and our children walked down to the lobby to get some food, and that's when Wilder and his hooligan friends bum rushed my husband, pushing me and my kids to the ground. My husband was punched in the back of his head, and Manuel Boxing was punched in the face. Let's be clear that Wilder was the ringleader in this terrible, violent altercation, completely uncalled for. I asked Wilder over and over to please not do this in front of my kids, and his response was, fuck your kids. This is who he really is, a disgusting person and a terrible representative for the WBC and the human race. So that's what Dominique Brazil's wife is saying. Again, ego was not there. I do not know. I will leave that up to you guys in the comments section. Shout out to all the people that left donations and tips. We working hard. I got a live stream Monday Mail Day. A lot of people are like, hey, why didn't you put the question form up? It's because I'm going live Monday Mail Day tomorrow with Troy King. And then we're going to answer some questions live from the gym. So that's why I didn't have a questionnaire form like I do normally. But rest in peace to Bill Paxton. As far as Wilder and Dominique Brazil, maybe they can fight now. I don't know. I don't know what happened in their situation, but I wanted to wait until a little bit more information came out. And that's Dominique Brazil's testimony. That's Deontay Wilder's testimony and Brazil's wife. You guys have all the facts. You make out what you want and drop it in the comment section. Make sure you share the video, like the video as always. Hate, comment, and subscribe. Till next video, it's Ego signing off.